Have you ever won first place in a contest? Or are you the second oldest in your class? If you wanted to talk about these experiences in Spanish, what would you say? This is where ordinal numbers, or números ordinales, come in. Ordinal numbers tell us about an object's position in relation to others. They are numerical labels to help us arrange objects or ideas in order. First, second, third, etc. They are different from cardinal numbers or natural numbers that represent a quantity we can count. For example, a cardinal number is 1. While the equivalent in ordinal numbers is first. In this video, we'll cover the vocabulary you need to use ordinal numbers in Spanish conversation, along with tips on how to form the numbers and use abbreviations. Let's get started. The most common números ordinales in Spanish are numbers 1 through 10. These are the easiest and the most frequently used by native Spanish speakers. Let's learn the ordinal numbers and hear examples of how they're used in a sentence. First is primero. Can you say that? Quiero ser el primero en la fila. Second is segundo. You try it.
Esta es la segunda vez que te llamo.
Wait. Why did I say la segunda vez and not segundo vez? Because we have to pay attention to gender. Keep watching and we'll go over all this in detail. Third is tercero. Can you say tercero?
Estoy leyendo el tercer libro de la serie.
Wait, why did I say el tercer libro and not tercero libro? This is because some of the cardinal numbers lose the O before single masculine nouns. Keep watching to learn more. Fourth is cuarto. Repeat after me. Cuarto.
Eres la cuarta persona que me pregunta eso.
Fifth is quinto. Can you say quinto?
Soy la quinta hija de mi familia.
Sixth is sexto. Try it.
Sexto. El sexto sentido fue una película muy exitosa.
Seventh is séptimo. Repeat after me. Séptimo.
Urano es el séptimo planeta desde el sol.
Eighth is octavo. Can you say octavo? We can use ordinal numbers when talking about measurements of quantities, such as
hay una caloría en un octavo de taza de espinacas.
Ninth is noveno. Repeat after me.
Noveno.
Es la novena entrada del juego de béisbol. Tenth is décimo. Can you say décimo?
El décimo mes del año es octubre.
Quick quiz! Give it a try! Pause this video after each number appears if you think you need more time.
El carro. El octavo carro.
Number 2.
El de noviembre. El primero de noviembre.
Number 3.
El suéter. El décimo suéter. El hermano. El quinto hermano. El cuadro. El noveno cuadro.
How did you do? I bet you did great, and you're starting to get the hang of it. Now, let's go a bit deeper and see examples of how ordinal and cardinal numbers are used in different situations and conversations. Ordinal versus cardinal numbers. Now that you know the ordinal numbers, it's important to note that we do not use them in Spanish exactly the same way that we use them in English. For example, to specify a particular date, we say the day of the month with the cardinal number.
Mi cumpleaños is el 10 de agosto. The only exception is for the first day of the month, where we use the ordinal number. Hoy es el primero de abril. Although, if you are learning Spanish in Spain, you'll notice that they might use uno instead of primero, and say, for example, el uno de abril. Grammar time! While cardinal numbers act as adjectives, ordinal numbers can be adverbs, pronouns, and adjectives. The major difference between them is that cardinal numbers do not usually change according to the gender and number of the noun, as ordinal numbers do. Let's hear some examples that show how ordinal numbers change to adapt to the noun they describe, while cardinal numbers do not. Hoy compré mi segundo carro. Yo tengo dos carros. Vivimos en la quinta calle. Vivimos a cinco cuadras de aquí. Me dieron el primer boleto. Tienes un boleto. Es la tercera vez que te llamo. Te llamé tres veces. Quick quiz, give it a try. Which ordinal or cardinal number do you need to fill in the following blanks? Pause the video after each number appears if you need a little bit more time to think. Tengo animales. Tengo dos animales. Tengo el animal. Tengo el segundo animal. Hoy es la vez. Hoy es la primera vez. Lo hago solo vez. Lo hago solo una vez. Comienza la entrada. Comienza la cuarta entrada. You just learned that ordinal numbers are often adjectives. Adjectives in Spanish generally come after the noun they describe. But in the case of ordinal numbers, they actually come before the noun, as you've seen throughout this video. One exception is when we're discussing a member of the royal family, or the Pope. The ordinal number comes after the noun. Juan Carlos, primero. San Juan Pablo, segundo. While there isn't a rigid formula for us to memorize all the ordinal numbers after 11, there are a few guidelines we can follow. For numbers 13 through 19, we use a combination of décimo and ordinal number 3 through 9, as in décimo cuarto. For numbers in between 20 and 100, we use the ordinal number ending in jésimo or agésimo, and the unique singular ordinal number 1 through 9, as in vigésimo primero. Let's get started. Both 11th and 12th have two acceptable forms. You can say undécimo or décimo primero for 11th, duodécimo or décimo segundo for 12th. Keep in mind that all of these numbers can be written together or apart, as in décimo primero or décimo primero. 11th, undécimo, décimo primero. 12th, duodécimo, décimo segundo. 13th, décimo tercero. 14th, décimo cuarto. 15th, décimo quinto. 16th, décimo sexto. 17th, décimo séptimo. 18th, décimo octavo. 19th, décimo noveno. 20th, vigésimo. 21st, vigésimo primero. 30th, trigésimo. 40th, cuadragésimo. 50th, quinquagésimo. 60th, sextagésimo. 70th, septuagésimo. 80th, octogésimo. 90th, nonagésimo, in 100th, centésimo. Similar to English, Spanish ordinal numbers can be written in long form or using superscriptions. While in English we use st, nd, erd, and f as the superscriptions, as in first, second, third, and fourth. Spanish uses O for masculine nouns and A for feminine nouns, as in the following examples. Primero capítulo is superscript with an O or with an R to mean first chapter. Primera dama is superscript with an A to mean first lady. Keep in mind that in informal speech, the use of ordinal numbers above 10 is fairly rare. Instead of saying el quincuagésimo capítulo, you would more likely say el capítulo 50. Now that you have learned how to use ordinal numbers, you'll want to keep practicing them regularly in speech and writing. At Homeschool Spanish Academy, we offer Spanish classes with certified Spanish teachers who are eager to help you master ordinal numbers and so much more. Check the description below for the link to our website where you can sign up for a free trial class to see how easy, fun, and effective it is to become fluent in Spanish with us. I hope you enjoyed this video. Leave a like and be sure to subscribe to our channel for all Spanish learning updates. Hasta pronto!